Hi, welcome to Nourish IT. This is Kishore, and today we are going to discuss about exception handling in C++. Okay, now today we are going to discuss the topic is what? Exception handling in C++. First of all, exceptions are what? Nothing but error causing. Okay, that means whenever we are writing the programs, we are getting some errors. Now we are giving solutions, pre-solutions for the coming errors. That means we are providing the solution for user getting errors through the exception handling. That means here the name is very clear. We are going to handle the exceptional part. That means whenever an error is occurred, what program we have to show. Suppose in C language, suppose for example in C language we are having, suppose one variable is not declared, but we are using the variable in our program. Then our system says what? Error, undefined symbol, that variable. How it is possible? Because of there is already a predefined program for that one. Now that error is created by whom? That is, that error message is created by whom? The author of C language, that is Dennis Ritchie. That means already Dennis Ritchie written a program for that error, and when that error is occurred, this message is automatically displayed on the screen. Now the user is easy to understand what is the error or why we are getting this error. Okay, based on that error message, user is going for corrections. Now the same thing we are going to provide for the C++ compiler through exception handling. Now how to handle the exceptions in our C++ programs? Okay, here some important point we have to discuss. C++, Turbo C++ 3.0 up to Turbo C++ 3.0, exception handling is not provided. Remember this, we are having Turbo C++ different versions. Up to Turbo C++ 3.0, there is no exception handling concept. In Turbo C++ 4.5 and remaining versions, okay, 4.5 onwards and remaining versions, we are having only the exception handling messages. Okay, that's why how to handle the exception handling. And actually we are having three types of keywords in exception handling. One is try, and another one is throw, and the third one is catch. Okay, in C++ we are going to handle the exceptions by using of three predefined keywords called try, throw, catch. Now what is called try, what is called catch, what is called throw? Okay, now try is a keyword which contains, try is a block which contains the error causing program. Okay, remember this, in try block we are going to write the error causing program. Next, throw is what? Whenever the error is occurred, we are going to throw some value through the throw keyword. That's why try contains what? Okay, try contains the error causing program. Next, throw is what? Whenever the error is occurred, throw is going to throw some value. Now when it is thrown by something, means we have to catch it or not, that catch is given in catch program. That means now the thrown value is going to receive by catch, and catch is going to receive the value. Now it is going to give the solution for that error causing program. That's why in try block we are having what? Error program. Now when error is occurred, the try block throws some value, that value is received by catch block, and it gives the solution for that thrown value or that error causing program. That's why they are interrelated with one another. Now how to display an error solution in our program? For example, suppose 5/2, suppose I have entered 5/2, answer is what? 2, because of integer by integer always another integer we are getting. Okay, no problem at all. Suppose 5 by 2.0, answer is what? 2.5, and something is displayed like this. Next, suppose user entered 5 by 0. Actually, everybody knows 5 by 0 gives division by 0 error, means it is causing infinitive. When infinitive is there, what happens? Our program is going to be hanged down. Okay, now to avoid this problem, what we have to do? We have to check the second value, or divisor is 0 or not. Suppose divisor is 0, here 5 is what? Dividend, and 0 is the divisor. Suppose divisor is 0, what we have to conduct? We have to throw some error message, that is conducted through exception handling. Now what is going, we are going to throw? Suppose any value. Now that value is received by what? Catch. Now catch block gives what? Division not possible message. Now what happened? The system is having required source. What is that source? Division not possible. Means remaining program continued? No, not at all. Now the program is closed. That means what happened? In place of system hanging, we are getting a result. That means remaining program continued, and it is not going to halt our system. Like this, we can bypass the errors by using exception handling. That's why we need the exception handling. And Turbo C++ 3.0 not supports the exception handling. Turbo C++ 4.5 and other versions, later versions, are supporting only the exception handling. Now I will show you how to cause an error, and how to throw a value, and how to give a response to the error through the catch block. Okay, I will show you, watch it, how the exception is handled. Okay, for example, I am going to conduct the example like this. Now I am going to use, for example, dev C++. Okay, now I am going to use dev C++. Because of Turbo C++ 3.0 version not supports this exception handling now, then how to work with the exception handling in dev C++? Just I am going to give that one. Clearly, I am going to give exception handling in dev C++. Now there is an important role in dev C++. What it is? In dev C++, C header file should be end with .h. C++ not like that. That's why first suppose hash include iostream, it is enough. Generally in Turbo C++, what we are going to close? iostream.h. But in dev C++, don't enter the .h. Next, because of it is a C++ header file. Next, hash include conio.h. Now, it is nothing but console input output header file for CLR, SCR and getch. Now, it is for input output stream, it is for console input output header file. Later, I am going to use using namespace std. Okay. Now, what happened? In dev C++, regular our objects like cout, cin, they are stored in std namespace. That is why whenever we are working with cout and cin object, we should have to use this namespace. Otherwise, every time you should have to provide std colon colon cout, std colon colon cin namespace. To avoid that problem, simply using namespace std. Because of in dev C++, what happened means our cout cin objects are stored in this namespace. Which namespace? Std namespace. That's why using namespace std. Later C++, normal Turbo C++ supports either void main, int main or only main. But dev C++ not supports void main. That's why you should have to start int main. Now int main. Okay, now the main part started. In main part, what we have to do? First of all, declare two variables. Suppose int a comma b. Because of our operation is what? I want to perform division of two numbers. I want to perform division of two numbers. For a division, what required? two numbers minimum required. That's why I have declared two variables. Okay, next one. Here I am going to use like this. Okay, what I have to do? Now we have to read some values. Where I am going to do this one means in a try block. Now try block is started because of already we have discussed the exception causing program should be placed inside the try block. Okay, actually what we are going to do, we are going to read some numbers. Later we are checking that number is zero or not. That's why reading where it is conducted in try block means here zero also entered in try block, no? That's why error causing program is listed inside the try block. Now try of what? C out, enter two numbers. Okay, C in, A, B. Now two numbers are entered. Later we have to perform what? Division of this one. But before going to division, suppose 5 by 2 there is no problem, but 5 by 0 is the problem, no? That's why first we have to check there is any chance for error. Now I am going to check it out. If B equal to 0, now the meaning is what? Actually when the divisor is 0, okay, there is a problem. When dividend is 0, there is no problem at all. That's why divisor is which one here? B. Now we are checking the B value. If B value 0, then what happened? We are getting the problem of system hang down. That's why to avoid this problem, we are making a exception here. If B value 0, then immediately throw something, any number, suppose throw 0. Okay, that means what? When B value becomes 0, we are throwing something. What we are throwing? 0. Suppose we are throwing the 0. Now we have to catch the 0, no? That's why now catch block required. That means what happened? When a throw keyword is occurred or when throw statement is occurred, program goes to catch block automatically by leaving the remaining lines. Okay, and now watch it. For example, here enter two numbers, A value for example 10, B value for example 2. Now check it out. A value 10, B value 2. Now B equal to 0 means 2 equal to 0. No, condition false. Now it is not going to throw anything. That's why condition false. False means it goes to next line. Next line I am doing like this. C out, division equal to directly A by B. Now, okay, return 0 not mandatory, brackets close. Actually what it is? Try block. Okay, now watch it. A value 10, B value 2. Now 2 equal to 0, condition false. Directly it goes to C out, 10 by 2, answer 5. 5 is going to print at all. That means here there is no error chance. Suppose user entered 0. Now watch it. A value 10, B value 0. 0 equal to 0. Yes, condition true. Immediately it is going to throw. Now it is throwing what? 0. 0 is what? Generally integer. That means this throw block is going to throw integer, no? Now we have to receive the integer in catch block. That's why this try block is having a catch here. Catch. What it is going to catch? Integer value, no? That's why int x. Now what happened? Say this. Suppose int x I have declared. Here what returned? Throw is going to throw the 0. 0 is integer, no? Now this one matched. Now that means what? When a throw is occurred, the catch block is going to receive the thrown value and it is matched with the parameter. See this, here we are throwing the 0 and here also integer. 0 and integer both are same. That's why it is going to receive this message and now it is going to respond. What it is going to give the message? C out, division not possible. Okay, now we are getting the message division not possible. Now you can use the return 0 statement, otherwise not required, because of we are going to close the main block here. Now the main block also closed. Now watch it, what happened? When B value 0, throw 0. That throw 0 is stored in INTX, means this catch block is going to receive the 0, and now it is giving the reply what? Division not possible. That means now the program is not going to hang down, because of there is a sufficient response from the system. What is that response? Division not possible. Later program is going to close, means not halted here. That's why it is called exception handling. That means how to make error free, okay, how to solve the errors by using our own methods, okay. It is called exception handling, and in exception handling we should have to use one is what? Try block. See that it is the try block, and try block contains what? The error causing program. Next, whenever an error is occurred, we are going to throw something, and that thrown value is received by catch block. Catch block is going to receive the thrown error, and it is giving the response to that error. Now your system is not going to be stopped or hang down. It is called exception handling. Okay, thank you for watching.